Good morning, boys and girls. It's Sunday school time again, and I welcome you to Sunday school. Your teacher today is Miss Rena. And today we have an interesting story for you. It's about Moses. And you may have heard about Moses in the Bible. He was a descendant of Abraham. Now, Moses was, let's get our Bibles. Let's sit in a cozy place and let's begin with prayer. Everlasting, eternal Father and God, through your Son, Jesus Christ, we come before you. We thank you for love. We thank you for your care. We thank you for your protection. We thank you for everything that thou has bestowed upon us. And as we come this morning to speak about your word, we pray that God, you'll be with us. You'll be in the midst of us. You will bless us and you'll guide us. You will open our hearts to learn what you want us to learn today, so that God, we might remember who you are and how great you are. Bless us today and bless these children and their parents. In Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. So boys and girls, this morning, your story is God cares for Moses. And the focus, God cares for us. So let's look at an interesting story about baby Moses. Let's begin. So our memory verse for today is taken from 1 Peter 5, verse 7. Give all your worries and cares to God, for he cares about what happens to you. Let's repeat that. Give all your cares, your worries to God, for he cares about what happens to you. 1 Peter 5, verse 7. And our scripture lesson comes to us from Exodus chapter 1, verse 22, Exodus 2, 1 to 10, and Exodus 6, verse 20. And Exodus is the second book of the Bible after Genesis, then Exodus. Very easy to find. So the story is about Moses. And I'm reading from the Bible at Exodus 1, verse 22. And here it says that Pharaoh gave an order. So Pharaoh said to all his people, every Hebrew boy that is born, you must throw into the Nile, into the river Nile, it means. But let us save the girls. All the girls will live. Now that sounds very hard for the king to say about little babies. But the king was trying to get rid of a certain set of people called the Hebrews. They are Israelites, and he didn't want the Israelites to be bigger and stronger than the Egyptians because they were living in the land of Egypt. So he decided that he was going to allow the girls to live and the boys to die because he knows that through the boys, the generation would become bigger and larger. And he was fearful that they would become stronger than the Egyptians. So it is out of a bad heart that he wants the little boys to die. So here comes Moses. And the Bible tells us in Exodus 2 about the birth of Moses. It reads, Now, a woman of the tribe of Levi, married a Levite woman, and she became pregnant and gave birth to a son. When she saw that he was a fine child, she hid him for 3 months. But when she could hide him no longer, she got a papyrus basket, just a special type of basket, for him and coated it with tar and pitch. Then she placed the child in it and put it along the reeds along the bank of the river Nile. His sister stood at a distance to see what would happen. So here in the picture is Moses' mom, and she coated the basket to make it waterproof, meaning water would not get into it. So she was brave, and she was going to ask God to protect her child, because she saw that she had a good child and she wanted to save this child. She didn't want Moses to be among the children that were going to be thrown in the river Nile. Instead, she wanted, as a result of putting on the Nile, he would be saved. So she made her basket, and there's little Miriam, who was going to be brave, the watchman or the watchwoman for this little baby who was going to be set on the river Nile. Interesting thought, yes. So let's read on. So here it says in Exodus 2, then Pharaoh's daughter went down to the Nile to bathe, and her attendants were walking along the riverbank. She saw the basket among the reeds and went ask a female slave to get it for her. She opened it and saw the baby. The baby was crying, and she felt sorry for him. This is one of the Hebrew's babies, she said. Then the sister asked Pharaoh's daughter, shall I go and get one of the Hebrew women to nurse the baby for you? Yes, go, she answered. So the little girl went and cut the baby's mother. Pharaoh's daughter said to her, take this baby and nurse him for me, and I will pay you. So the woman took the baby and nursed him. When the child grew older, she took him to Pharaoh's daughter, and he became her son. She named him Moses, saying, I drew him out of the water. Exodus 6:20. Amram married his father's sister, Jochebed, who bore him Aaron and Moses. Now, so we know that Moses' parents were called Amram and Jochebed, and he had a brother called Aaron. So Amram lived for 136 years. Let's continue our story. Now I have 2 videos for you. I want you could pause and watch them, or at the end of the story, you could go back to the slide and watch them. They are so interesting. But in the meantime, I'll share the story with you. So the story says, here I'm giving you the story line by line. The story says, the children of Israel grew up to be big and strong and had to work hard for Pharaoh. King Pharaoh said, I will take away all the baby boys before they are stronger than me. So you can see the Pharaoh, which was the ruler of the land of Egypt, he was very jealous, and he didn't want the Israelites to grow bigger and stronger than them. They took them for slaves and they were working them so hard. But as they worked them, they were growing even stronger and bigger. And he was fearful that they would come and overthrow him or take his place. So here, Miriam, she was the brother of this beautiful baby. So Miriam had a beautiful baby brother. She often looked out of her window to see when the soldiers came. Then the family hid the baby and prayed that God would keep him safe. Soon, their baby was too big to hide. His mother made a special little bed in a basket to float the baby down the River Nile to a safe place. God will look after him, Jochebed said. That's Moses' mom. She tucked him in her bed, and he fell asleep. God keep our baby safe, she prayed. Miriam, his sister, watched nearby. Then the baby began to cry. Miriam saw a princess come down to the river. The princess found the baby and she loved him. I will call him Moses, she said, but I need someone to help me to look after him. Then suddenly, of course, the princess saw Miriam and sent her to find a lady to feed the hungry baby. Miriam ran home to get her own mom and said, the princess needs you to look after the baby. When he was bigger, Moses went to live with the princess, like the Bible said, in King Pharaoh's palace, the own palace of the father who didn't want the Israelites to live. Moses always loved God with all his heart and knew that God had kept him safe. So, boys and girls, wow, interesting story. Here we see in this picture when the princess, who is Pharaoh's daughter, came down to the river and find the baby that the brave mom, Jochebed, and little Miriam had left to float on the river. Can you imagine? The mom, Jochebed, Moses' mom was so brave. She prayed that God would keep her baby safe. So she puts him on the river and left the little girl, Miriam, to watch. Here's a picture. And now we see where the princess comes down to bathe in the River Nile and found Moses. And Moses, she asked the little girl asked, shall I go get someone to take care of the baby? She agreed, the princess agreed. And now we see in the picture where Moses is older and Jochebed brought Moses to give back to the princess. So Moses was going to grow up in the same palace of Pharaoh who wanted Moses to die. Can you imagine? That is such an interesting story today. We can see how God cared for us and how God cared for Moses. And remember, Moses was a direct descendant of Abraham. And God had told Abraham that he was going to make him a great nation. And that descendants, he would have family and relatives like the sand on the seashore or the stars in the sky. So Moses could not die because Moses was going to be part of that great nation, that great descendants of people that were going to be from generation to generation. And so God found a way to save Moses. This is an interesting story, boys and girls. So we remember that the story said to us that Moses was from the tribe of Levi, and Levi is one of Jacob's son, Jacob was the grandson of Abraham. So this is the expansion of the great nation that God told Abraham about long ago. Moses was one of the descendants of Abraham. And you've read some of those stories before, so you know what I'm talking about. So boys and girls, this was a great story, and this is showing you how God can care for people, and he cares for you just the same. So let's continue. So here we see, we will talk about what we learn from today's story. So let's focus on that. That was a really interesting story, boys and girls. So here we learn that Pharaoh did not like the Israelites. As you will see in the videos that you're going to watch, they were stronger and in great numbers in Egypt. Pharaoh was scared that the Israelites would take over his kingdom. He worked them very hard as slaves, thinking that they would die. But they grew even stronger. And that was what made him so scared, that they were going to come and take over. It was jealousy. So Pharaoh made a rule to kill all newborn Hebrew boys by throwing them in the river Nile. When Moses was born, his mom, Jacobed, knew he was a special child. So she hid him. She hid him away from everyone so the soldiers who were taking away the young babies would not take him. When she could no longer hide him, she put him in a secured basket and placed him among the reeds, which we call the bulrushes, on the river Nile while Sister Miriam watched. Pharaoh's daughter, the princess, came down to bathe in the river and found Moses. Miriam, Moses' sister, who was watching, asked Pharaoh's daughter to allow her to get someone to care for the baby. Next point to remember, Miriam called her own mom, who was paid to take care of her own child, all because the princess was going to be the one to save this Moses until he became big enough or old enough to do God's purpose, to do what God saved him to do. And as you read later in different stories, you will learn how Moses became great, a great warrior for God, because God had saved him for his own purpose. So we know that God took care of Moses. And so, boys and girls, God will take care of you too, as you will see in these pictures that I'm putting up for you. God cared for Moses, and he will care for you too. It says, God is faithful, and he will take care of you if you trust him. God sees everything, and he will take care of us if we trust in him first. Just like he took care of Moses, there's little Miriam's eye watching the basket floating on the river among the bulrush. Whatever the test, God will take care of us. And as this person wrote in their hand, God cares for us. So boys and girls, we see Jesus and God in the form of Jesus taking care of these little children. And so he will take care of you too, like he took care of Moses. That must have been frightening to leave your own child on a river. But boys and girls, we see in the lesson, the memory verse says, give all your worries and cares to God, for he cares about whatever will happen to you. And thus we have a wonderful story today. The memory verse, I want you to remember it. 1 Peter 5, verse 7. Let's say it again. Give all your worries and cares to God, for he cares about what happens to you. Boys and girls, the story was very interesting today. And I hope you learned something from it, because I know, you know, that God can take care of you. So boys and girls, I want you to especially remember these important points that led to the story developing from how Jacobed hid her baby so that he could become great for God. And we saw how God took care of him. And similarly, God will take care of you. Boys and girls, I thank you so much for listening. I thank you that you will, I hope you will have a wonderful week. I hope you will enjoy your week. Remember to take care of yourselves. Always wash your hands and protect yourself, and so that God will also protect you. Bye for now, boys and girls. See you next time, and have a great, wonderful week. The Lord bless you. Thanks for listening. Bye now.